Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Oscar, and this is my first video ever made for YouTube. I've decided to make a little series of guides about Life is Feudal Your Own, which I've played for several hours. According to Steam, I'm at like 190 hours, so I've got somewhat of an idea how this game works, and so, yep. I came up with making a guide explaining some stuff that isn't shown in other YouTube videos, maybe not. So, character creation always starts with giving the character a name. My name is Oscar, because Oscar with one R is already taken on the server, which is my main character, sure name. God damn it. Place. So gender, yeah, male. I'm not the guy that runs around or likes to run around with a female character and getting aroused by looking on the boobs and whatnot. Next thing, choose is a race. There are pretty much three races, or three races in this game. They are pretty straightforward. We've got the Gottlung, which are more or less the human, the normal, they all are human-like. But in other MMOs, the Gottlung would be the human, which are like average in all their traits. We've got the Slavat, which are the guys from the north. They are a bit taller and stronger, sturdier. And we've got the Core, which are a bit more agile and so on. I personally always choose the Core, because they have a bit higher base willpower, which determines how much stamina they have and how much they can carry. My tongue. Okay, next, appearance settings. Well, as in most of the games developed by indie companies, it's not that really great. The variety of choices I have: three heads, one normal, one recently got beaten up, and one after some healing. Got some facial features, such as can't even tell. Some dirt on my face. Some tattoos, okay. Not much into that hairstyle. Let's see. Oh god damn, no. I don't even I don't even no, I'm not going to play this over hours and look at this stuff and what looks pretty wildish. I actually kinda like this. What else do we got? Pocahontas. Thanks. What is that? Bit emo like? I'm not sure about that one. And, well, yeah. Okay, I think I'm gonna take this. Where was it? The bonehead ponytail. Okay, facial hair, as in beard, no, night, oh no, maybe, what else do we got? Oh yeah, kinda, it's, okay, nope. Oh, this looks kind of weird. This, no. Where was it? Smallish, mustache, thingy. Nope. What's easy top? Just okay. Hair color. Okay, a bit underwhelming. Body features should be again some tattoo. stuff and things. Okay. No. Gonna wear some clothes anyways, soonish. Skin tone. Yeah, okay. Attributes. What do we have here? Generally, the attributes are linked to the to specific skills. For example, if you use, let's say, heavy plate armor, you need to get the best effect of them. You will need high constitution and high willpower because it's heavy as fuck, and yeah, you need that. And also, you got some global effects out of the attributes. Strength determines the damage you are dealing, either with melee as with ranged weapons. Agility is like the precision you have on ranged weapons. Constitution is directly your health. Willpower is your stamina, and the stuff you can carry in your inventory, when you will be encumbered, is determined by your willpower, and intellect may give you some additional skill points. Crafting skills. This thingy is just for the stuff where you get started with. I'm personally playing on my own server with the skill cap of 3000, so I'm going to do pretty much everything on my own, as opposed to the normal servers with a skill cap of 600, so 5 times less, where you actually need to play in a group of players to get stuff done. So this here is for me just important for the first 1, 2, or 3 days. With what I know about the game, I want to have terraforming at 60 right off the bat, so I can directly start digging tunnels in order to get my hands on iron or to make better tools and weapons and stuff. All the other stuff, yeah, comes over time. Combat skills. The last thingy. What do we have here? Warhorse handling, yeah, it's mounted combat. Since I'm going to play this stuff here more or less solo in a PvE setting, obviously, I won't really need mounted combat, which is a bitch against animals in game. Militia service is, the benefit of militia service is that the armor and the weapons are rather cheap to make, but not that great, at least in the PvE department. Blades mastery is something useful. Can use one-handed weapons and shields. May be useful with multiple players to be like the tank. Two-handed blades mastery. Yeah, what should I say? It's running around with two-handed blades, two-handed swords, bastards, claymores, flambers, and so on. And throwing weaponry is the skill that throws with weapons, no, uses weapons that throw around or shoot with stuff, such as slingshots, later on crossbows or bows. Which is, in my opinion, for what I'm going to do, the best thing. So I'm getting this rather high right off the bat. Also because skilling up slingshots is really a bitch. So I wanna get this rather high right on. We have points left? No. That's it. What's gonna name her? Okay, everything set. Going to done. Okay, this is my other dude, which I'm not going to use now, obviously. Going to play, and oh, the game is loading. This is one of the huge downsides of the game. It takes forever to load, and the servers have the slight tendency to crash. Like, all the time. No, not all the time, because if it would be like that, I would have stopped playing by now. But they sometimes crash. Well, let's use some time up. A few words about me. I'm Oscar, coming from northern Germany, raised and born. Here, I'm 37 years old, playing for a long, long time. Video games, I mean. Only on PC. Started with games such as, what was the first stuff, was stuff like Age of Empires, Diablo. Not Diablo 2, the one before that. If someone remembers this. If you actually have played this back in the days, you're as old as me, but that's cool. After that time, at some point, I started with Half-Life, ran into my first FPS game. Started playing Counter-Strike for quite a while, been rather active there. Then switched over to this whole MMORPG thing in 2001, I think it was. Dark Age of Camelot came out, and now I'm in game. Takes a second to render in all the stuff, or maybe a few more seconds. Dark Age of Camelot, and yeah, I spent years and years with playing all the MMOs. But always return to Dark Age of Camelot. I've played this for overall like 6 or 7 years, maybe longer, I don't quite remember. Later on I played with my guild games such as Warhammer Age of Reckoning, Guild Wars 2, what else? Arc Age recently, Elder Scrolls Online, so all the competitive MMORPGs with a focus on PvP. And nowadays I'm more into the more survival sandboxy games such as Ark Survival Evolved, DayZ, and now Life is Feudal. And here we are. I said sandbox, I said survival, and obviously I end up on the beach after character creation, of course. I'm almost naked. Yeah, everything good. Survival sandbox game. So I hope you kinda liked the video so far. Or my series, so to say, because I'm going to wrap this one up. And we'll see us soonish with the next video. We are getting into all the tools and stuff you need or want to make in the beginning. How to get started, what to do, how to not starve, and everything to just get started into this nice world of Life is Feudal. This is Oscar. I hope you're having a nice evening, rest of the day, good day at work or whatever. See ya hopefully soon. If you like this, don't forget to get